Hello students, welcome to EPG Patashala. I am Professor I.K. Ravichandra Rao. I was earlier working in Documentation Research and Training Center of the Indian Statistical Institute, Bangalore. Today we are discussing on analysis of circulation data and library statistics. This is a part of the course on Scientometrics. This particular model has got several objectives. One of the important objectives is to highlight the importance of circulation data. It's most often neglected in most of the libraries. In order to analyze the circulation data, we should have a certain data on certain things. For example, what we should have in a circulation transaction record. This is very important, and this is we are going to learn in this particular model. For example, I believe in a circulation record, we should have data about the user, data about the user who borrowed the document, data about the document which was borrowed, and about the time aspect. When was it borrowed? When it is supposed to be returned, etc. Now, the third objective is to examine the studies on analysis of circulation data and their application. Now, examine the studies. There are several studies carried out either in India as well as in abroad. Some of the important studies we will discuss it. The fourth objective is to discuss its applications and some relevance now, and also to profile the elementary types of library statistics. Now, the outcome, learning outcome, that means on completion of this course, we expect that you will gain a knowledge in the area of analysis of circulation data as well as on library statistics. The circulation section of a library is the one which comes in contact with the users most. It is one of the most visible section, hence Dr. Ranganathan has portrayed it to the tip of a temple tower, as it is a library is a simulated to a temple. The circulation in a library is a dynamic section with several associated activities with outputs of a vast volume of data that can be used for a better collection management and development. Several studies and models on the use of circulation data or circulation transaction records for analyzing the collection of a library and use the same for a collection development and a management are available. Circulation statistics suggest that a document borrowed most frequently by the same or a different borrowers is more useful than one borrowed less frequently. The concept of a resource sharing might be correlated to the cooperative collection development policies based on the heavier behavior of a transaction records. So the data of a circulation transaction is a very valuable and has multiple implications in the use of library collection, as it is discussed in the unit 3 and use studies. It's a complementary to the application of this unit. Now, by analyzing the circulation data, we often come to a conclusion: 80% of the library collection is hardly used. Maybe it contributes about 20% of the total circulation. In other words, 20% of the collection only used again and again and again and again, and it may contribute to 80% of the 80% of the total transactions. Similarly, analysis of a circulation data tells us it is the 20% of the users contribute 80% of the transactions, and it's the 80% of the users hardly contributes to the total number of transactions, about 20%. We will have several such interesting observations in the analysis of circulation data. So, not only circulation data, for example, there are several statistics which are useful in the day-to-day administration of statistics. For example, how many books you classify in a month, how many books you catalog in a month, how many reference queries you answer in a week. Such statistics are known as library statistics. We should maintain such statistics, and there are several standards how to maintain, how to use, etc. Elements of a circulation transaction record. Well, in any circulation transaction record, we should have three important data. Who borrowed it, what they have borrowed it, and some kind of a time concept. Now, who borrowed it? We should have user's information, at least user's name, and some ID number. And what he has borrowed? Documents. Now, the title of the documents, and the author of the document, and the year of publications. Third one, the time concept. When was it issued, and when it is due. This minimum information should be there in any circulation transaction record. When the circulation transaction is completed, that means after the user returning it, date of return, maybe number of times the item is borrowed, and the number of time the user used it can be generated, as well as it can be stored there. Circulation transaction record consists of several variables, as I said, and help in decision making in the context of collection development. The quantum of statistical data on a circulation work is of high magnitude and is implied in the improvement of library services and in the collection development and collection evaluation. It is stated, analysis of circulation data gives information related to the volume of use by type of documents and by type of users, use of documents of different age, seasonal variations in transactions, and so on. The circulation data of a transaction records could be taken as an indicator of the use of the library resources. The borrowed documents, document data, along with the borrower data, provide information, and it can be used by the management for formulating and adopting policies for acquisition and processing of documents. The transaction record of a document or documents over a period of time, decisions on a weeding or deaccessioning the collection. Circulation data of a library provide several indicators and can be utilized for a collection evaluation, improving the collection and the library services. Now, Truswell was the first one, in fact, to analyze the circulation data. He's one of the pioneers in this field. He did his studies in 1964. He discussed the problems involved in forecasting document use based on the transaction records. He also came out to the 80-20 rule in this regard. According to this rule, approximately 20% of the library holdings will account for about 80% of the circulation. Turner evolved identifier method and developed rules in non-library-oriented areas of identification of low-use items. Morse, also in 1968, shown that the distribution of number of times a book is issued follows a Poisson distribution. Ravichandra and Burrell have shown for a large data set, the distribution of transaction follows a negative binomial model. Ravichandra Rao has shown that the transaction of documents over a period of a time manifests success breeds success phenomena. Roswell revised studies in the form that time gap between the date of last circulation and the current date, and this time gap is termed as the idle time of a document. The idle time is described as a book might have been used 20 times 20 years ago. Another book might have been used only once a week, only once, but a week ago. It is quite likely that the chances of a later book to be in circulation in the near future much higher than the chances of the former. In this sense, the last date of the circulation is a quite important element. It gives a lot of information about that book usage. So another revised interpretation, as it is only those documents which are circulated recently are likely to be circulated again and again, be made about the circulation data. The circulation data can be correlated to several other variables. It can be used in teaching methods adopted, changes in circulation, and the examination procedures adopted in the universities. It's possible to correlate the circulation data with the overall objectives of the library, physical facilities available, hours of charging and discharging functions in the library. The circulation data using the user document, user and documents characteristics with the age of the user, gender of the user, status of the user, level of a document, subject content of the document, etc. It is possible to map a library usage. Analysis of a circulation data and its applications. The implications of the analysis would be to identify a pattern relative frequency distribution, to identify a pattern of a relative frequency distribution of documents in the collection in a given period of time. The proportion of the circulated documents to the total collection of the library. An analysis of the deals data in terms of its usefulness to library management, developing a technique for collecting data, identifying the types of deductions that can be made from this data. With regard to the evaluation of a collection, there is a need to evaluate library services, the awareness of their social responsibility, the ever-increasing needs of users, and the financial constraints on spending. These are the three factors which lead us to evaluate the library services. Now, general procedure or a research design for evaluation studies are determination of the object and the reason for evaluation, setting the level of performance according to the objective, selection of technique for evaluation, preparation of a scale to measure the level of performance, measuring and determining the extent of achievement, evaluation as per the measurement of achievement. Evaluation processes are comprehensive evaluation covering all aspects of library, for example, Carl White's survey of the University of Delhi library system. The study checked standard bibliographies to assess the strengths and the weakness of the collection, used questionnaires and interviewed teachers and students to measure user satisfaction of the library services. Goldow suggested in inductive method a complete list of library holdings in a specified subject, and it is compared with the several book reviewing and book selection tools. Of course, as I mentioned, Roswell's 80-20 rule. This is a very important rule which was identified by analyzing the circulation data. The rule states, Approximately 20% of the library holdings will account for about 80% of the circulation, which has been evolved by the author by conducting several investigations and publishing research papers. Lancaster and Baker, in their study, Applied Collection Use Studies, discussed two types of quantitative data, interlibrary loan statistics that reflects a time demand and a circulation statistics that is met demand. Now, in another study, they utilized in-house use in a public library. The methods applied to collect data are table count, slip method, use of questionnaire, and interviews. The findings of the study are: level of in-house use varies widely among the libraries. Circulation and in-house usage correlated with each other. Older material received less in-house use. Lancaster, in two more studies, observed, covering the quantitative data of circulation records, in-house use, document delivery, and a shelf availability, and has explained that circulation follows a hyperbolic distribution, that is, a small number of items circulate a lot, while most books seldom circulated. Now look at this particular data. Here, the variable x referred to number of times circulated. F of x referred to number of documents. For example, 964 documents circulated 0 times, 435 documents circulated once, 184 documents circulated twice, etc. Now, there are about 1,895 documents in this particular distribution. Now, this can be represented in a graphical form. I will explain it, how the graph looks like and how to draw the graph. Now, say for example, this data, unused document is about 51%, and average is 1.35 circulations per document, and those are all the statistical parameters related to negative binomial distribution. Let me not talk about that here. And now look at this graph. In x-axis, I have taken cumulative number of documents, that is 0%, 20% of the documents, 40% of the documents, 60% of the documents, 80% of the documents, 100% of the documents. Cumulative number of transactions are plotted in a y-axis, that is 20% of the transaction, 40% of the transaction, 60% of the document. In an ideal case, if all the documents are valued, we expect that 20% of the document contributes 20% of the circulation, 40% of the documents contribute 40% of the transactions, etc., in which case we will have that blue line. But for this data given in this table 1 earlier, the curve looks like the red color. The curve is in red color. Now you can see the gap between the red color and the blue color. It is very high here. That means there are large number of documents which are unused, very few documents which are used heavily. Very, very few are used less. This type of a curve is called a Lorentz curve. And if you draw a Lorentz curve for the circulation data of your library, you see how it looks like. If the gap between the red and the blue is very less, that means it is a well used. Take for example the future graph, another graph I will show you. This is another set of data in economics. And look at this graph. Very, very few documents are heavily used, hardly used. You can see so many documents are unused. 80% of the documents are unused. Look at it. Now, there's another set of data for a library science. You can see here. See, this is a much better graph than that. Only 40% of the books are unused. We can even evaluate e-resources. There are IFLA guidelines to evaluate e-resources and it comprises e-resources, comprise e-journals, e-books, full text databases, indexing, reference books, etc. Now you can evaluate even the e-collection based in a similar way, the way you evaluate the documents based on the number of circulations. Now, simultaneously, we should maintain certain statistics in a library. We call it as a library statistics. It is quite important to have library statistics as well as to follow certain standards. Libraries are community service institutions, and community expects them to be run efficiently. The administrators and the managers of a library must have some data so they can judge the overall idea of working of the library. The modern library certainly cannot now be operated as though it were a passive repository for printed materials. The librarian should know as accurately as possible what is going on, and should be able to predict what probably will be going in the future. This is where the application of statistics comes into picture. From simple numeric or arithmetic calculations, such as number of books available, acquired, etc., the librarians are now gradually developing and are using a statistical model to describe various aspects of a library use. There are certain standards for a library statistics. According to IFLA, the libraries and information services serve society by preserving memory, feeding development, enabling education and research, and supporting international understanding and a community well-being. ISO 2789:2006 specifies the rules for library and information services community on the collection and reporting of statistics. Since 1968, NISO has maintained a national standard for library statistics. It's called ANSI bar NISO Z39.7. The Bureau of the Indian Standards 12940, documentation, library statistics guide issues 1990. There are ALA standards, etc. There are several types of library statistics: statistics of a technical department, statistics of service departments, and other statistics. Statistics of a technical department refer to classification, cataloging, book acquisition, periodicals, serials, barak. For example, how many books you classify in a week or in a month or per year, how many books you catalog in a year or in a month or in a year. Now, statistics of a service department, how circulation section, reference section regarding the who borrowed what, when, etc., and a reference section, how many reference queries you are answering, long-term and the short-term reference. The statistics of other departments refer to administrative, such as library staff, their strength, qualification, experience, special skills, etc., library budget, and the physical facilities. There are several studies in this area. The most important studies referred to Pittsburgh study, Sliss study of the University of Western Ontario, and Morse's study, the University of Chicago. In fact, Morse has observed that the distribution of circulation follows Poisson distribution. However, Ravichandra Rao and Burrell have observed that the distribution of transactions follow a negative binomial distribution. Troswell has observed the most important two things. One referred to 80-20 rule, other one referred to the last circulation date. See, there may be two books, for example. One book might have used 20 times 20 years ago. But then one book might have used just last week. Now, at the outset tells me the first book is quite important, but then it also tells me the fact that it has been never used in the last 20 years. The second book might have used only once, but it was used in the last week. So it gives me some clue that the second book is quite likely to be used again in the near future. So circulation data indirectly helps us to helps us to weed out a document. If a book is not being used even once in the last 30 years, we can as well weed out. This is one of the most important application of analysis of a circulation data. Application is, if a book is used very frequently, several times, that means if there is a demand for that, we can even think of buying multiple copies or reduce the circulation, the period from 15 days to 7 days, or just to put it in the our overnight issue only, etc. So analysis, we must develop a habit of analyzing the circulation data very frequently and make use of its results in the day-to-day administration. Thank you very much.